So let's solve the equation 2z squared minus 13z plus 24 equals negative 8z plus 30. So the first thing to notice is this equation has a z squared in it, which means that this is a quadratic equation. And since this is a quadratic equation, we'll use the quadratic formula. Now, the owner's manual for the quadratic formula does require that we have our equation equal to zero. And so for our first step, we need to get all the terms onto one side of the equals. So now our equation is in the form it has to be to use the quadratic formula. So let's copy down the formula. And we can read off our coefficients. B is negative 5, so every place we see B, we'll replace it with negative 5. A is 2, so we'll replace every occurrence of A with 2. And C is negative 6. So we'll replace C with negative 6 everywhere we see it. And we'll do some arithmetic simplification. And we have our exact answer in radical form. Well, almost. Remember, the plus or minus in the quadratic formula means we actually get two solutions. So our actual solutions will be 5 plus the square root of 73 over 4, and 5 minus the square root of 73 over 4. Now, when we enter these answers into MyOpenMath, we'll need to be careful that what we're typing in is what we actually want. And here it's very important to watch the preview, because the preview tells you what you've actually entered as your answer. Well, so our answers are 5 plus the square root of 73 over 4. And a comma to set off the second answer, 5 minus square root 73 over 4. And if we look at the preview, we see what we've typed is not what we wanted to type. And that's because this expression 5 plus square root of 73, 5 minus square root of 73, is the numerator of a fraction. So we'll have to enclose the numerator in parentheses. Nope, that's the entire fraction. We'll fix that. We'll put the numerator in parentheses. And only after you've confirmed that what you've typed is what you want to type should you hit submit. And since the preview shows the answer we want to enter, we'll click submit. Now there is another option if you don't want to wade through the sea of parentheses. In the questions where an algebraic expression is expected as an answer, there will generally be this yellow up arrow when you click inside the answer box. And if you click on this yellow up arrow, it will open up a math formatting window. And we can use this to enter our answer exactly as we want. So the answer is a fraction, so let's hit the fraction button. We'll type in our numerator. And for the square root, we'll use this square root button. And we'll finish entering our numerator and denominator. Since the only difference between the first and second answer is that one of them is plus the square root and the other one is minus, we'll just copy and paste and change that plus to a minus. Once we're done, we'll hit save to enter the expression into the answer box, and we can press submit once we're sure that what we've typed in is what we wanted to type.